Get ready to match the stars from the new show in the beginning, McLean Stevenson, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, from Sugar Time, Dee Carr, Richard Dawson, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. Here's the star of Match Game 78.
I greet you one and all. Nice to have G.D. Carr with us back again, that singing, dancing fool from Sugar Time. And look here, Father who?
Father Cleary.
Father Cleary.
Oh, I thought it was Father Time.
No, now.
Well, no one will know what you're talking about.
Yeah, now he's got a series in which he plays Father Cleary. When
that's
does
right,
that start?
Right here on CBS. Yeah. I think whenever the new shows on CBS start, that's when we start.
Yeah, have you started shooting them yet?
Crossed their heart and said they would.
Yes.
No, we're what, July 5th today is?
Yes.
Because I know. I was setting firecrackers and stuff yesterday. Well, we start working in about a week, and okay. The show will be on in September.
Well, good luck with that adventure. That's marvelous.
Now, here on Match Game 78, we have our new star wheel, a way to win as much as $10,000 on one single match. And Kathy Krebs is looking forward to that. She has $350 to her credit, and she's going to start with that head-to-head big audience match here and see if she can win $2,500 or $5,000. She's going to spin that wheel and see what happens. So come right back after this.
Can't do that.
All right. There's that big new star wheel. Now, I want to point out to you, Kathy, that with the aid of this wheel, you can win as much as $10,000 on a single roll here. However, you've already had the first part of the audience match, which you won $250, multiplied by 10 is $2,500. However, let's go back here and see whether you're going to play for the $2,500 or whether you're going to play for double that amount of money, $5,000. Now, here's the way that goes. You see, every celebrity's name is on the wheel. And you give it a spin, and you will be playing with whichever celebrity the wheel stops at. Except if it stops in the gold star area there, you will double the money. Are you ready for that? Now, it must make one complete revolution. So grab it up here, and let's see if you can spin it real hard now so it turns around at least once. And good luck to you. Go. That was mighty powerful spin, and let's see if she's going to skip, double the money, and stop in the gold star area and play for $2,500. Or... Oh! Well, listen, you're going to play with Brett Summers for $2,500 here, and good luck to you now. This is the question that'll get you the money if you match Brett. Blank fiction. Blank fiction. F-I-C-T-I-O-N. Blank fiction. All right, Kathy. Give us the answer that Brett has written down. We give you $2,500. Blank fiction.
Science fiction.
Science fiction. I like that one. Okay, Brett, you said science fiction will match you for the $2,500. What do you say to that?
You know, I'm probably the only person in the world who doesn't read science fiction.
I don't either.
I don't know what made me say it.
Science fiction!
Congratulations, you now have $2,850. Kathy Krebs is a big winner here. Congratulations. Now let's bring on Saul Gorelick here. Here comes your new opponent, Saul. Hello, Saul.
What do you say there?
Hi, Gene. I'm from Brooklyn.
And, yay!
And I'm president-elect of the Brooklyn TB and Lung Association.
Okay.
And
yes?
If I may just say, I've been married for 36 glorious years. I have two remarkable children and one delightful two-year-old grandson.
Wonderful.
That's the story of my life so far. Oh, and I mustn't forget my grandniece Rena, who's a fan of Match Game, and because of her, I've tried out for this program, and here I am.
How old is she?
She's 12.
She is.
Yes.
Listen, I know. I can you see this at home? It says I, and there's a heart, and underneath says New York. That means I love New York. Is that what that means, Saul?
It sure does.
Yes.
I love New York.
I'm with you. I will always love New York with all its warts and all its problems. It's a wonderful place there. Saul, you may have A or B.
I'll have B for Brooklyn.
Okay, Saul. Anything to say? Fred said my new doctor is a quack. Because instead of a hypodermic needle, he tried to vaccinate me with a blank. He's a quack. Instead of a hypodermic needle, he tried to vaccinate me with a blank.
Is a blank?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do not discuss your answers in a loud voice.
Sorry, I'm sorry. Oh, it's been 3 years since I played the game.
Has it been 3 years?
I think so.
What kept you away so long?
I thought I'd get more than a dippy handshake and a basket of fruit, but I suppose there'll be a big fast party afterwards.
Terrible jackets, and on the last show,
that's
he
right.
Showed up in a bow tie and nothing else.
Hello, Saul. Fred said my new doctor is a quack because instead of a hypodermic needle, he tried to vaccinate me with a...
A gun.
You have a ticket back to Brooklyn. Paid for, prepaid. Yes, okay. Everything gonna be all right, Saul, one of these days. He said gun, McClane.
I know what he said. You know, up until that point, I would have voted for him. No.
He lost, yeah.
Wouldn't have been surprised if he had his own show. I, like a silly goose, said phonograph needle.
Phonograph needle is good. Anything except a conventional doctor's needle would have been acceptable here.
It would be sharp on the ends, right?
Sure.
Well, you know, I've just moved and I've been into heavy carpentry.
Yeah.
So I said nail.
A nail. That's good. A dumb doctor would do that. A quacky
sure.
Doctor. Yes.
A rusty nail.
A rusty nail. Very good. Yes.
You will.
He's, then you don't get lockjaw because he puts that anti-tetanus stuff on there. What have you got there?
A thermometer?
Thermometer.
I don't know.
Now that's a dumb answer.
Yeah.
A quack could make a mistake like that.
Oh, that's
yeah,
right. A dumb quack. Doc. Oh, yes. Quack.
Me,
right.
Rich.
I forgot about
it. I thought it was a legitimate.
Yeah, it's okay.
Now, I have not just moved, and I wrote knitting needle.
Knitting needle. Yeah. That is good.
I'd like us to know where we're going.
Right.
Keep our whereabouts known.
Okay.
I didn't match, but that's not a dumb answer. What else would you give a shot with except a gun?
That's a shot.
Yeah, a shot.
Uh-huh.
But this is a vaccination. I said a ballpoint pen.
Yes. That's good. A vaccination. You know, a vaccination is when the doctor takes a needle and dips it in the serum and goes...
That's thrilling.
Next. Well, we've got a question for you, Kathy. So don't go away. Right now, we want to do a little business with America. The other round one question, Kathy, for you, reads as follows. The Hollywood producer said...
Uh-oh.
He says, I've heard of bad casting, but this is ridiculous. The studio's doing the Charles Bronson story. For the starring role, they picked blank. Isn't that a good one?
It's a very long one.
No.
I didn't...
Could you read it again?
Show that didn't hear it.
Hollywood producer said,
yes.
The studio
yes.
Is doing. I've heard of bad casting, but this is ridiculous. The
yes.
Studio is doing the Charles Bronson story.
Uh-huh.
For the starring role, they picked blank.
He and Jack Lugman used to be roommates.
Jane,
really?
So were you and Jack Lugman.
Did you hear? Hollywood producer said, I've heard of bad casting, but this is ridiculous. The studio is doing the Charles Bronson story. And for the starring role, they picked blank. Don't say it yet. They're not quite finished.
Oh, wait a minute.
You know
okay,
who Charles Bronson
it.
Is?
Yes.
He's a guy with a mustache.
He's married to Jill.
I don't know who he's married to. I've only met him.
I think they're
married to Jill Ireland.
Jill Ireland.
Jill
excuse
Ireland.
Me.
Yes.
That
yes.
Won't help you with your answer, but
no.
They have a house in Vermont.
Yes, they do.
She rides horses.
The only time I've ever seen him is
17 dogs.
That's right,
he's
and a lot
horses.
Of kids.
Eyebrows, isn't
he? He's had heavy
well,
eyebrows.
John Ireland, I'm sorry.
No.
He happens to be in... He's one of the most gentle men I've ever met in my life. You know, he plays such an animal.
That's
he
right.
He's a darling man,
Charlie.
Really.
I saw him in Woodstock, Vermont, in the grocery store right. with about 8 kids.
I know.
And I said, what are you doing here? He says, what are you doing here? I said, well, I'm just to... Anyway.
You sound like you had a brilliant conversation with
yes,
him.
Yes, right.
What are you doing here? What are you doing? I came here to ask you what you were doing here. Well, I was here so you could ask me what I was on.
I was passing through, but he's got a horse farm out
there. Well,
that's
easy for you to say.
Yes, it is. The Hollywood producer said, I've heard of bad casting, but this is ridiculous. The studio's doing a Charles Bronson story. What are you doing here, Charles? For the starring role, they picked...
Howard Cosell.
Howard Cosell. Now, that would really be so ridiculous, I don't think anyone over here would imagine doing such a thing.
No, I did enjoy the dialogue between you and Richard.
Oh, thank you.
Are we on when the red light is showing and is pointing at us?
That's right.
So it's stupid to lay out really funny stuff when it's on somebody else, right?
Well, no, your mic is on.
I mean, I don't want to waste dynamite material if I'm not on camera. You know what I mean?
You don't have a thing in the world to worry
about.
I've
got a lot of funny stuff I wanted to say, but I didn't want to say it while you're showing Betty White, you know?
No, well, now, wait a minute. The way it works here, McClane, yeah. you see, yeah. you've been so long, you forgot.
Okay.
Mark Breslow is so quick.
Yeah.
As soon as you say your first syllable, he'll be on you. Now watch. Now, you can't see a monitor from here. I was going to demonstrate there because, you see, if she were talking here, the minute you said syllable two, he'd be on you.
Oh, I see.
So okay. you just well, you right, jump in any time you want.
Now, he's the director.
He's the director in the control room,
can you go, because some of us are taking notes. This is so stimulating. Can you go just a little slower?
Yeah.
I don't want to, because we should be playing the game.
Yes, right.
But we're talking about you and your experience with Charles Bronson and the
yes.
grocery store.
Well, I really didn't have an experience with him. That's
I
right.
Understand.
For you to see.
I understand.
Now.
Give an answer. Okay, I'm
you
ready.
Mustn't pay attention when you're
right.
doing material.
We could
stuff.
All help challenge. Why don't we all challenge Mark? And
I just want to, because now the producer's getting uptight. I just want to ask you. Is any of the stuff we're doing here today going to be in the midterm? Because I'm really... I want to get everything right.
Yeah.
Here's my answer. Now, see, he didn't pick him up.
That's right.
Sure.
Now, don't hurt Jennifer's feelings. She's sitting
now,
over there, sweet kid, dear.
And
Hollywood producer said I've heard
of
bad casting.
He got a laugh on the knitting needle line, and I didn't on the phonograph. Because they would be. Got the plot thing.
Yes,
they got
right.
those signs working.
Yeah,
right,
that's
fine.
Right.
All right.
I've heard of bad casting, but this is ridiculous. The studio's doing the Charles Bronson story. For the starring role, they picked...
Mickey Rooney.
Very good. That's one possibility.
Standing ovation.
Yeah. And you, my dear?
What was that all about?
I don't know.
I just had a little piece of trivia. I thought it was really weird, really strange, and I thought they'd probably strap her down. I said Raquel.
Now, that's good. See, because he's so masculine and macho and all that sort of thing, to cast a woman in the role would really be ludicrous, right,
sure.
Chuck? What do you say, Chuck, baby?
I went for someone who has the same eyebrows and the same upper hair that he does.
Who's that?
Benji.
Benji. For the starring role, they picked...
I am the only one with a normal answer. The only one. Howdy doody.
Howdy doody. That's right. He had big eyebrows, too, didn't he?
Well, I thought of someone rugged and strong.
Powerful.
Paul Lynde.
Paul Lynde, yeah. Okay. Looking for Howard Cosell, Miss White.
Who's looking for Howard Cosell?
Nobody here is.
The problem is that I guess I got the names kind of triggered. I was thinking Charles Bronson and Charles Riley.
Charles Riley, yeah. That's right. Show us your bushy eyebrows.
No, I could play a role like that.
Sure you could. Where are we here? No score. The end of round one. One of you will score before the day is through. I can feel it in my bones. Watch this.
Today's consolation prizes are first, La Machine by Moulinex, the incredible food preparation system from France, like having a professional chef right at your side. And from World Book Childcraft International, Childcraft, the How and Why Library, 15 volumes filled with stories, art, music, and facts about the world we live in. And a hot lather machine, and a supply of Trident sugarless gum. The sugarless gum with five delicious flavors to choose from, including bubblegum, Trident, for families who care about their teeth. And from Menace, put your hair on a high-protein diet with Protein 21 Shampoo Hairspray and Conditioner from Menace. On we go with the star of our show, Gene Rayburn.
And Johnny O. All right, round two coming up. Saul, do you want A or B?
I'm sticking to B for Brooklyn.
Anything you say, Saul. Gorelick. Dumb Donald is really dumb.
How dumb is he?
Get your act together. He bought a Volkswagen Rabbit and he filled the tank with blank.
And you turned out front.
He bought a Volkswagen Rabbit and he filled the tank with blank. That's how dumb he is. Fill the tank with... Okay, Saul, Dumb Donald is really dumb. He bought a Volkswagen Rabbit and he filled the tank with...
wine. I guess listen, I'm the one that's dumb.
You said it, not me. No, but, see, I leaned on it as hard as I could. He bought a Volkswagen Rabbit.
Rabbit.
And he filled the tank with, you get it now?
No.
Well, wine is your answer, but if you had a second choice, what would you say?
Probably milk.
Yeah. Well... I'm not going to burst your bubble, Saul. I'll let one of these up here do it.
No, I think the man is to be commended for his fresh air and healthy lung work.
Yes.
And his marvelous speech at the top of the show. There wasn't a dry eye in the audience by the time you got to the grandchildren. But on a scale of dumb, the man is about a plus 12 when it comes to the game. Now, he has done nothing but make me feel better.
Right. Because you probably got a rotten answer also.
No, I put carrots.
Carrots! You understand now, Saul?
I was thinking liquid.
You're thinking liquid. Yeah, but when I said Volkswagen Rabbit...
Say it one more time.
Oh, all right. Okay.
But you see, Saul's one of those people who expects logic from this show. You should know better, my darling. There are a bunch of dingbats up here. I said lettuce.
Lettuce or carrots? Anything a rabbit eats. What do you say?
Go to Erasmus High School. Erasmus High?
Morris High School in the Bronx.
Yay! Oh, I was born in the Bronx. I said carrot juice. Yay!
Carrot juice. Now, that would be good.
That made sense.
That's very good. Yeah. All right, Dee Dee Carr, what do you say?
I said lettuce.
Lettuce? All right, we got to keep that rabbit going.
Carrots.
With carrots. Lettuce or anything a rabbit eats there, Betty.
Well, you feed them pellets, too.
Right. Yeah, what are those, compressed carrots or something like that? Well, no, they're not doing so good. No, he's not doing so good. Well, neither one of you have scored yet. Here we are, last question, last round, last game. Mean Marvin is really mean. To teach his dog to play dead, he blanked it. Mean Marvin, really mean. You, on a question like this... puts you between a rock and a hard place, doesn't it?
Yes.
While we're waiting, we should thank
lovely Susan
Sue.
Spar there.
Lovely lady who brought us all Kentucky.
Louisville, Kentucky.
With all the winners on it.
Really?
And this year, Mr. Ed is a favorite. But Sue, thank you.
That's sweet of you to do
thank
that.
You.
Here we go, Kathy. Mean Marvin is really mean. To teach his dog to play dead, he blanked it.
Killed it.
Yeah! Killed it. That'll teach it.
We could possibly have our first fight.
Okay.
Because I remember if I give an answer that's close to hers, but it isn't right on the head, Tinkerbell over there blows a horn or shoots a gun or does something.
Buzz. You get the buzz. The buzz. Right, right.
Okay. I say, now, in deference to actors and others for animals, because I know Betty's about to, you yeah. know, whoop on this yeah. one. I said shot.
Shot.
Saul, I'm sorry to see you go, pal.
I'm happy I was here to meet one of the heroes, my heroes of early television, Gene Rayburn. Yeah.
Thank you very much,
you
sir.
You are a child star.
I'm a child star.
Wait a minute. Don't go. Saul, come back. I want to talk to you. Saul! Saul! Come back, Saul. Oh, forgive him. Turn it back. Do what I tell you to do. I'm a star. Wait a minute, that's enough. Whoops.
Now don't move it again because the cable is caught inside the thing, and I will just get it out here now. All right. Now, what were you saying, Saul?
As I remember, I was saying that you were one of my heroes of early television. You are a child star. In those days, long ago, you're going to give me another thrill.
Yay, Saul! Yay, Saul! Okay, a little message for you. Here. I'm Gene Rayburn, hoping you'll join us next time here for Match Game 78. Goodbye!
Speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Fixon, Bill Trotman production. This program was edited for broadcast.